Today, let's talk on cybercrime investigation. I am Harshita Jadhav from RAS Security. Let's see what is meant by cybercrime. Cybercrime or computer-oriented crime is a crime that involves a computer and a network. The computer may have been used in the commission of a crime or it may be in the target. Cybercrimes can be defined as offenses that are committed against individuals or groups of individuals with a criminal motive to intentionally harm the reputation of the victim or cause physical or mental harm or loss to the victim directly or indirectly. Using modern telecommunication networks such as internet, like a network including chat rooms, emails, notice board and groups, and mobile phones, that is Bluetooth, SMS, MMS, cybercrime may threaten a person or a nation's security and financial health. Issues surrounding these types of crime have become high profile, particularly those surrounding hacking, copyright infringement, unwarranted mass surveillance, sextortion, child pornography, and child grooming. Let's see what is meant by cyber investigation. A cyber investigation is an electronic method conducted through electronic system to search and discover the online facts and information. Cyber investigation is the process of law enforcement officers used to track criminals via the computer. This process may be to investigate computer crimes or it may be to track records of criminal using computer forensics. To conduct a cyber investigation, the officer usually first receives a complaint from a victim. For example, in the case of a person who ordered goods from a website but never received the product and was still charged, the officer would take the victim's statement and follow up with the company in question. By reviewing charge receipts and the company's financial statements, he can determine whether the internet fraud had been committed. For other crimes such as pornography or computer hacking, the officer conducts his cyber investigation with software designed to track internet movements of specific users or internet addresses. When the software alerts the officer that a specific website has been accessed or compromised, he can gather information regarding the user's identity by tracking his IP address back to a specific service provider. A warrant will be required to get the actual name of the user and other pertinent information such as addresses and phone number from the service provider. Once the warrant is served, the officer can arrest the violator. Copyright or royalty infringement is another area where cyber investigation may be necessary. This is most often an issue for the music industry with unlawful downloads. With the invention of the MP3 player, many websites have allowed free downloads of individual songs or entire album of music without paying the record company or the artist, scanning artwork or stealing written work and publishing it. The internet is also a copyright infringement, that is, malicious viral attacks are more commonplace as criminals become more computer savvy and business use computers and the internet more in their daily activities. A viral attack or virus is a term used to describe a deliberate introduction of computer code intended to the harm software or hardware. When the criminal sends virus via an email, for example, it may cause the recipient's computer to delete or modify files, send the virus to everyone on the same network, or even shut the entire computer down. In extreme cases, viral attacks have infected millions of computers, causing the significant downtime, lost earnings or revenue, and sensitive online records to be compromised. For large-scale viral attacks, the FBI may conduct a cyber investigation to pinpoint the origin of the virus and attempt to create a computer code fix. If the originator of the virus is not found, he may be prosecuted if the virus was intentional. The investigator Investigators' investigations help client by privately investigating cybercrime that can't be solved otherwise. We have become the international go-to source when it comes to cases that involves technology, the internet, and case strategy, including international jurisdictional boundaries. If your issue involves criminal or civil matters and you need help, give us a chance to find the most economical solution for you. Okay, let's see some data retrieval types. There are two types. First one is internet based. If the case is internet based, finding the internet protocol address is your first step in the investigation. Address consists of number and letter, and that series is attached to any data moving through the internet in order to retrieve an IP address from some internet service providers. You will need to subpoena, warrant, or court order the company for information. What an IP address contains, who owns and operates the network address, associated domain name, computer name, geolocation, email addresses, and the local service providers. All ISPs are based on subscription to the company. These companies have record of everything their subscribers do while on the internet. The time frame that ISPs retain data from subscribers varies. Therefore, the investigation must move quickly. As the investigator, you can make a formal request to the ISP requesting they preserve the data in question. While a subpoena, warrant, or court order is made requiring the records, even with this letter, ISPs preserve the data for law enforcement. Second one is device based. If possible, place the device in a Faraday bag prior to turning on and examining the device. If a Faraday bag is not accessible, turn the device into airplane mode. This will prevent any reception or remote communication. A copy of the original data is needed prior to investigating its content. Having a copy of the original data prevents the contamination of the evidence, cell phone, and other wireless devices. Should be examined in an isolated environment where it cannot connect to networks, internet, or other systems. Those topics I have taught you, these are the basics of cyber investigation. What is meant by cyber investigation? What are the types of data retrieval? What is meant by cyber crime? There are lots of other cyber crimes are included in the cyber investigation. Okay, let's see one or two examples of real cyber investigation cases. Tampering with computer source document. In case of manipulation, this is the case of Tata Indicom company, right? In the case of manipulation, Tata Indicom employees were taken into custody in the relation to the tampering of the electronic 32-bit ESM, that is programmed into cell phones. The theft was for Reliance Intercom. In a verdict on a later date, the court said that since the source code was manipulated, it calls the use of Section 65 under the Information Technology Act. Let's see another case. BSNL unauthorized access. In a leading cybercrime case, the Joint Academy Network, JANET, was hacked by the accused, after which he denied access to the authorized users by changing password along with deleting and adding files, making it look like he was authorized personnel. He made changes in the BSNL computer database in their internet users account when the CBI carried out investigation after registering a cybercrime case against the accused. They found that the broadband internet was being used without any authorization. The accused used to hack into the server from various cities like Chennai and Bangalore, amongst others. This investigation was carried after the Press Information Bureau, Chennai, filed a complaint. Let's see one of the BPO fraud. In another incident involving Emphasis India, four call center employees gained the PIN codes from four of the Emphasis client, Citigroup. In spite of not being authorized to do so, various accounts were opened in an Indian banks under false name, and within 2 months, they managed to transfer money to this account from Citigroup customer's account using their PINs and other personal information. The cyber fraud case occurred in December 2004, but it wasn't until April 2005 that the Indian police were able to identify the individuals to make an arrest. It was made possible with a tip provided by US bank. When the accused tried to withdraw cash from these fake accounts from 42 lakhs that was stolen, only 23 lakhs were recovered. The accused were charged under section 65, that is the tampering with computer source or documents. That's it. Cybercrime investigation, it is the field where we can investigate the internet-based data like chats, email, retrieve the whole history of the computer. So that's it. Whatever I have told in the tutorial, these are the basics of cybercrime investigation. What is meant by cybercrime? What are the aspects? What are the cases which I have told? One or three cases. Those cases are real and investigated by CBI or FBI. Thank you.